Hey you and welcome. I'm Mr. Barry. In this whole video, I want to talk about installing the Chrome OS right onto your Windows-based laptop or even into your old MacBook. Now, I did make a video about this a number of years ago, and the link will be up there. Basically, what we did back then was we would go to neverware.com, and from there, you'd click on Download Neverware. You would download onto a jump drive, and then you would boot up your computer from the jump drive. From there, you would given two options. One, you can actually run the Chrome OS right off the jump drive, or you can actually format and install the Chrome OS onto your Windows or Macintosh machine, basically removing Windows or Mac and replacing it with the Chrome OS. Well, a few things have changed since then. Basically, back in December of 2020, Google actually acquired Neverware. And you may ask, well, why didn't I make a video on that day? Well, because Google, when they acquired it, they didn't make any changes. They basically kept it the same. There were some minor updates to the operating system, but everything ran smoothly as before. Things are still running smoothly, by the way, but there are now changes, and it looks more like the real Chrome OS that you'd actually run on a Chromebook or a Chromebox. So that's why the update of the video today. So let's take a look at this, you and I. Come on. Hey, here we are in the Chrome OS Flex version. Now, the main difference that you have between the older Neverware's version of the Chrome OS and the actual Google Chrome OS Flex version is that down at the bottom there, you actually have the app launcher, and the app launcher looks and acts just like the real one on a Chromebook. So instead of having everything like and highlighted in blue and there's some other minor changes in the design, it looks and behaves the same way. So if you look at the bottom there, you notice that the app launcher is over there on the corner, and then towards the middle we have the shelf and the apps that are basically pinned onto the shelf. And so we have the Chrome browser, and then a few of the others there. Now, if you click on any of those, they work just like you would expect in a Chromebook, which is really nice. And what we're going to do is actually go in and show you from the link that I have provided in the description of how everything works. So notice right here, it says click here to get the Chrome OS Flex version. So you click there. And next, in a moment or two, you get this page. Again, it basically says the same thing with a little bit more information. So if you'd actually to scroll down on this page, you'd actually see some more information, such as some of the features. Let me speak about some of those now. Chrome OS is very secure. In fact, it's probably the most secure operating system that you can ever run on a computer. And the Chrome OS Flex carries that along. So if you're looking for security, and we know we all are, boom, the Chrome OS Flex has you covered there. The other thing that you will notice is that you have the Chrome Web Store that is supported, and so extensions or apps that you'd actually be running in the Chrome OS, they run perfectly fine, and there's no problem there as well. So those are two really good features that have been carried over to this operating system. The other thing that you can do too is, if you're part of a larger company, you can control or actually manage the devices within your enterprise or your company, so that there'll be one admin and you can either enable or disable features from one location in one place there. All right, so let's go ahead and just click on try there, where it says try Chrome OS Flex. And now it comes up to here, it says try an early version of Chrome OS Flex for free. Now, if you remember from the previous videos I made about Neverware and that operating system, it's 100% free. And again, we're finding the Chrome OS Flex is also free, which is a good thing. The major change is this right here. Some people may not like it, maybe actually be turned off by the fact that they have to put in a name, an address, even a phone number there, and all that information that you'd provide there. Some things that might hang up people would be, it says company and then company size. Well, you can make up a company, and as far as company size, you can say, well, it's just one person. So there you go. And once you've answered all those questions, notice at the very bottom there, you have a blue button there, and you can actually click there. And what happens at that point is you'll have to have your jump drive handy. Now your flash drive or your jump drive, whatever you want to call it, needs to be ready, and you'll put that into your computer, plug that in, and then have the Chrome OS Flex version download onto this. What's going to happen is it will format, so if there's any data on this jump drive or USB jump drive there, it's gone, and it will be replaced with the actual Chrome OS Flex. The nice thing about this, that's what's created, is called a bootable device. So a bootable device is basically a device that can boot up your computer system. And what you'll do is after it downloads, and well, it'll format and then download the operating system onto your jump drive. From there, basically turn on your computer, plug this in right away. And if you need to, you need to change your settings on your laptop so that it actually boots up from the jump drive. And there's a few ways to do that. Right when you if you have a Dell computer or most other computers, you can press F11 or F12. It comes up and it asks you, well, which device do you want to boot up from? Well, guess what? You just want to boot up from the USB device, and away you go. It'll allow you the option to either run it from the jump drive or to install the Chrome OS Flex right on to the machine and overriding the old Windows or Macintosh operating system that you had there. By the way, I do have instructions on that depending on what kind of computer you have, whether it's a Mac or a Windows laptop, and those steps are over there on the previous videos. Don't really need to repeat those steps because those steps are up there and it's fairly easy to go to. Now let's look at some of the things now as far as what does Chrome OS Flex lack? What is it missing? And this is a biggie. Now, I was really, really hoping that the Chrome OS would have this one feature. Many of my subscribers have been messaging me and saying, hey, does it have it yet? Does it have it yet? And the answer is no, it does not have the Play Store. Now, the Android Play Store is like crucial or central in many of the things that we do inside of a Chromebook. And you're going, you got to be kidding me. It doesn't have the Play Store from Android. And as of today, which is February 2022, it does not carry the Play Store. Now, does that mean that it'll never have it? Well, not exactly. It may carry it in the future, so hopefully it will. Thing is, you can actually, if you have an older laptop, you want to give it new life, this is an excellent way to basically give new life to an older laptop or an older MacBook. Another question that comes up often on my comments there in my videos is, well, can you actually install this onto an older Chromebook and then update it to a newer version of the Chrome OS? And the answer is we're not looking at that. This is for an older Windows machine or an older Macintosh machine. All right, if you want to go ahead and do that to a Chromebook, you'd have to actually change some things in the machine itself so that you would actually be able to boot up from a jump drive and actually install an operating system there, which is a little bit different than what you normally do on a Chromebook. All right, so we now know some of the features. It has great security. It runs and does things from the Chrome Web Store. So it does run the extensions and the apps that you find there. And then some of the things to know of installing. It's very easy to install. Just have to answer those questions that we talked about earlier. And then click on Try Chrome OS Flex. It'll put it onto a jump drive. The thing it lacks is the Play Store. Ouch. And that is a big ouch, because we really do like having that. And hey, thank you for being here with the video. If you haven't done so already, please subscribe to my channel and click on that bell icon to receive notifications when new videos are uploaded. And if you do like these videos, please click on thumbs up, comment down below, because I love to read your comments. And I really appreciate everyone there. And my channel has really been growing as of late. And I just really wish to thank everyone out there for being able to watch the videos and share the videos. All right. Thank you again very much. And bye-bye.